love a cup. I would. Oh, God, yes. Oh, that is gorgeous. I need a cup of the brown stuff, the shade of an acorn, made warm by the same source that I take my cakes from. Using a teapot, a mug, or fine china, been hooked up to IVs, need constant supplies, and a drip for my urges might verge on perverted. But for earthy brown tea, I'm certain it's worth it. With Sherpas who work hers and use a fresh fountain, I've discerned brews from Peruvian mountains. I've slurped up a cuppa from an elephant's trunk, with a couple of monks who utterly stunk. I've had bourbons with sultans and creams with queens, and I've bathed in Earl Grey. I'm really that keen, and missionaries dismiss me for my single epiphany. The dip between him and me is a simple sip of British tea. So when times are hard and life is rough, you can stick the kettle on and find me a cup. Now when I say Earl Grey, you say yes please Earl Grey.
Yes please
Earl Grey.
Yes please.
When I say Assam, you say lovely Assam.
Lovely
Assam.
Lovely.
When I say ooh, you say ah. Ooh, ah. Ooh, ah. Ooh, ah. Ooh,
that's gorgeous.
Not wrong. I've been around the world in 80 brews to see the place it takes me to make a brew that tastes like the cream cakes made by angels do. I'm not the same as you, get shaky but aim to swig amazing fluids but don't make it the same. Now using fine leaves picked by pretty maidens in a bag knitted by a seamstress who lives in Copenhagen, brewed up in a pot made of semi-precious metal, let the blessed content settle in my very special kettle. Now when I say ooh, you say long. Ooh,
long.
Ooh,
long.
When I say herbal, you say no thanks. Herbal.
No thanks.
Herbal.
No thanks.
No. No, I want milk in it. Strong though.